season regardless, but this will hurt. Oh so close. But you don't get prizes for being oh so close.
And the pain can be greater than anything else in football, missing out in the playoffs. Yates, whose presence effectively forced the goal, which looks increasingly likely to guide Nottingham Forest back to the Premier League. A whole generation has grown up without Premier League football at Nottingham Forest. Wembley trips used to be an annual, sometimes biannual affair at one stage.
It's been overdue, hasn't it? An understatement. This is it now. This is it. All of Karlskog run, waving everybody forward. Doesn't matter now if they concede another one.
A season in 30 seconds here. Everything resting on this. And Jed Spence meets it. Dwayne Holmes.
It's a painful one. He's just trying to do the right thing, which is help it back into an area, Dwayne Holmes. But it's on his weaker foot, he can't control it. And that, you suspect, will be that.
Corbran, very gracious. It is Nottingham Forest time again. A generation has grown up without Premier League football at the City Ground. But they will experience it once again. The first European Cup came 43 years ago tomorrow. The second, 42 years ago, yesterday. It is another glory day in May for Nottingham Forest. They've had to show real resilience all the way. A desperate start to the campaign. That's why Steve Cooper is here. He picked up the reins when they were rooted to the bottom of the table. At the end of the season in May, they chase the ecstasy of playoff triumph and they claim the ultimate prize. They feel like they've been playing knockout football for some time now, and they've certainly got a taste for it. Sometimes it's been brilliant, but it was all about digging in here, Don.
Yeah, I have to say, Steve Cooper's post-match interview after they progressed in the second leg against Sheffield United summed the playoffs up and what it takes to win a playoffs absolutely perfectly. You've got to play well, you've got to be resilient, you've got to dig deep, you've got to ride your luck at times, and you've got to keep battling and battling on and see where it takes you. Well, they've got the dream ticket now. And you have to say, on the balance of play, really, there wasn't an awful lot in it, but if one team probably edged it, it probably was Nottingham Forest. And I think the stars of the show were their defenders. I have to say, not a single shot on target for a Nottingham Forest goalkeeper to have to deal with. That, in a playoff final, is perfect defending. Congratulations to them. Commiserations to Huddersfield.
And just before we saw Jordan Smith there, now my mind goes back right now to 5 years ago, the final day of the season. Forest were playing for survival in the Championship. They could easily have gone down to League One. He made a stunning save from Dominic Samuel of Ipswich at 0-0. They went on to win the game. supporters. 23 years. You go back to the days of Ron Atkinson walking into the wrong dugout at the City Ground. A desperate season after they had briefly enjoyed the high life again under Frank Clark after the end of the incomparable Brian Clough era. But the message from Wembley is that Forest are back.
Means this bunch of supporters that have travelled down from the East Midlands, 23 years away from the Premier League. This generation of Forest players has made a little bit of history here. They've taken the team back to the Premier League for the first time this century. This will mean a lot to the players, it'll mean a lot to the players and the players' families and the fans. It'll mean a hell of a lot to this man. Let's get the thoughts of Joe Worrell.
Joe, congratulations. As a lifelong Forest fan and the Forest captain now, what does this mean to you to be taking Nottingham Forest back to the Premier League?
Honestly, I'm just so proud, so proud of the players, of the staff, fans. We've been fantastic all season. I thought really unlucky to not go up automatically, in my opinion. I thought we were really good value. We played with honesty. We played football the right way. And look, incredible.
There has been a yearning from the fans to get back to the top division. Have you felt that more and more as the season's progressed?
Yeah, like I keep saying, we've been really good. And not just this season. I'm not saying we've been good in the past seasons, because we've been shy, but it's been a long time coming that this club hasn't been in the top flight, and seen a lot of good people come and go, and they've all added to a little bit, 0.5% to this football club, and it's fantastic. Such a honour to captain Forest.
Joe, it's understandable with your emotions, but we must apologise for your language there. What about today's game? Second half, Huddersfield got on the ball a bit more, but were you always confident that you could see it out?
We don't mind suffering. We've suffered for a long time off the pitch, so half an hour is nothing compared to what we've suffered for so many years. And I just want to say a big thanks to everybody who's helped us. Everybody. I'll forget names if I even attempt to reel them off. But we've been really, really, really good value this season, and I'm just so proud, especially for the manager. Such a nice bloke, and he's failed twice in the playoffs before, and I'm absolutely made up for him. You can see it in his eyes when he talks to you in the dressing room, around the place. He calls me on my days off, and I'm Steve Cooper, what's he want? And he's just checking up on me, checks up on all the players, and he's fantastic. These little things that the people don't know about, really, really nice, genuine man, and I've made up for him.
You were bottom of the league when he took over, so what on earth has he done to you?
Given his unfair belief. I keep using the expression of like a whipped dog. If you treat any dog with kindness, then they become a nice dog. You know what I mean? If you mistreat one, then they're aggressive. And we've been a mistreated team. And I think he's come in and he's given us that hope, given us that belief. And he's just been so nice. He's just killed us with kindness, and the fans absolutely adore him, and I've made up for him. He's fantastic. He must be feeling so happy, and he deserves every single corner that comes his way, because he's been immense.
Every dog has its day. It's your day today, Joe. Well done, congratulations, go and enjoy it.
Thank you, cheers.
I get the sense that he will enjoy it very, very late into the night. Articulate, passionate, empathetic, thoughtful, kind, caring, the type of leader Nottingham Forest fans absolutely love. Another one that they absolutely loved is getting lots of love here pitchside as we watch Steve Cooper, Bree Samba taking the plaudits, the deserved plaudits. This team, this group of men has made Nottingham proud. Stuart Pearce, can you try and sum this up?
I think the Forest captain there summed it up really well. I think he spoke very well. Him, McKenna and Cook went to see the opposition at the end of the game, which I think was a classy touch by all three of them. And the stadium's bouncing now, and Nottingham Forest will be a massive credit to the Premier League next year. Let's spare a thought to Huddersfield. You know, deservedly well done, really well getting here today. But I think probably over 90 minutes the better side won.
Said it was a closely fought game, and it's heartbreak, of course, for the Huddersfield Town players. Couldn't repeat the heroics of 2017. But Joby McEnough, Nottingham Forest, they've not seen Premier League football this century.
Listen, we're very, very privileged to be at games like this, occasions like this. And I've got to be honest, I don't think I've seen a reaction like this. I mean, literally, the place has gone absolutely ballistic, as you can hear. And it feels, Bruts, like 23 years' worth of pain and suffering and heartache has just erupted, exploded. All the emotions are coming out. And listen, it is a fantastic football club that has suffered. These fans have suffered. They go week in, week out. And it's just great to see them being able to share this moment. Brilliant, brilliant scenes, and fully, fully deserved over the season, yes, but also today they came and executed the game plan the best.
Hef, of course, let's just pat the Huddersfield hat for just a second. We'll come on to them in due course. The Terry is terrific over the course of the season, but how does it feel to win at Wembley in the playoff final? What are they feeling now?
Big congratulations to Nottingham Forest, such a massive club. You see just the supporters here, they obviously deserve Premier League too. It means a lot for all the players, and I think it sums it up that Steve Cooper comes to Nottingham Forest, sort them out, and they deserve it. You have to say this without a doubt. This man, he deserves every praise, because I texted him when he take over this job. If you can turn around Nottingham Forest and you get them to the Premier League, you're maybe the next Gaffer from England, you know, as a laugh. But he did it, and big praise to Nottingham Forest. Well done.
The main gist, of course, is playing the game, not the occasion, Stuart. Now they can celebrate the occasion, can't they, Nottingham Forest?
I certainly can. And well, listen, the atmosphere inside the stadium is quite incredible. I'm not sure I ever played at Wembley in a Forest team that had this sort of atmosphere. That's how much it means to this football club. They've waited a hell of a long time to actually get back into the Premier League. And well, certainly myself, you that have been there and stepped out of the city ground, very, very proud of their achievement.
It's certainly a moment to share, it's a moment to savour. If you were a Forest fan, this is a moment of pure euphoria. Joe Worrell making his way up the Wembley steps. He has captained Nottingham Forest back to the Premier League via the playoff final. For the trophy lift, Don Goodman and Daniel Mann.
Supporters, as louder as I'm sure you have ever heard at a playoff final.
Yeah, I've been coming here since 2007, my first playoff final, championship playoff final. I grew up at the Sky Sports. That final whistle, that's the loudest reaction. The hairs on the back of my neck stood up, and I've been there and seen it and heard it all before, but not quite like that. I mean, it's been an incredible barren spell for Nottingham Forest, but the drought is over, and if ever a club deserved it, I think we have to concede this club deserve it.
Well, it couldn't happen to a nicer bloke. And what a reputation he is building, a reputation burnished still further. Steve Cooper, to this club when they were very much on their knees on the bottom of the table. They were close. They pushed for automatic promotion, and when you miss out on that, there's often the potential that the heartache is just too great to get over.
at Bramall Lane in the semi-final. A different kind of performance today, but in many ways just as good. Jewell will receive his medal, following in the footsteps of legends as a Nottingham Forest captain. Huddersfield players gathered on the pitch watching them. Lewis Grabban is the club captain, we shouldn't forget, but absent through injury. Well, maybe a touch of relief that it's all over. They've got through the game. He said, you can do everything right and still end up on the losing side on an occasion like this. His old club pretty much did that last night, Liverpool against Real Madrid in Paris. But they have got it right. They managed to keep their opponents at arm's length and do enough themselves to win the game. And that is what it's all about. Steve Cook, he's done it the old-fashioned way. It's a different and very enjoyable experience. One or two famous faces in the Royal Box, it would be fair to say. Johnny Owen and Vicky McClure there. A few legendary Forest names in there, including our old friend Gary Birtles as well, who enjoyed this occasion more than most, I'm sure. The financial prize is huge, but the football prize is as big as it gets, and it belongs to Nottingham Forest. And it is richly deserved.
Nottingham Forest players. There's not a single free Nottingham Forest seat in their side of Wembley. Every single Reds fan has stayed. Every single Reds fan has stayed here to watch these players lift this trophy, which confirms their return to the Premier League for the first time in 23 years. Bottom of the table, Stuart, when Steve Cooper took over. Now they're in the Premier League.
I think that's the most exciting thing about today's victory. The dedication, turning the team around, getting the results that they needed just to get here. You know, and that's certainly credit to Steve Cooper. He'll take all the plaudits and come probably tomorrow morning. He'll have his eye on the Premier League and a potential building process to keep Forest in the league.
Joby, we saw the game against Bournemouth just a few weeks ago when they were going for second. That doesn't matter now at all, does it?
No, it doesn't, but I spoke to Steve Cooper after that and he said as long as we take something from that night, as long as we learn from the experience, he understands they've got young players in the squad and he felt that that could help them a little bit further down the line in the playoffs, in big games, and learn how to handle big occasions, and I think they certainly did take something from that.
My God, this is a very noisy Wembley Stadium, quite rightly so. If you're going to celebrate once in a generation success, why not do it right here at the home of football, in the biggest game in domestic football? It's Nottingham Forest promoted back to the Premier League. Big game today, big games coming up for you on Sky Sports. On Wednesday, Scotland take on Ukraine in that playoff semi-final for the World Cup qualifiers at 7 p.m. Then next Sunday, the winners of that game will face Wales. 4 p.m. Sky Sports Football. And the second season of The Flight Attendant. All episodes available now on Sky Max. My word, it is loud here in at Wembley Stadium. This is what it means to the players. This is what it means to the fans. Listen to this, Nottingham Forest fans. You are back in the Premier League.
McKenna's on hand, but so too is Garner. Garner to Whippy.
Sheer emotion on Steve Cooper's face and a very simple message on that Nottingham Forest flag. They are indeed going up. They've won the Sky Bet Championship playoff final by the solitary goal, and that's all it needed to send them back to the Premier League for the first time in 23 years. Scott McKenna was the man of the match. Here he is now.
It doesn't get much better than that, does it? Can you put it into words for us?
Nah, I don't think I can put it into words quite yet. I don't think it was the best of games, but the main thing was we got the result and we won promotion.
And you did it for fans, a sea of red today, 23 years outside the Premier League. Could you feel their desperation, determination to get back there?
Yeah, we felt it ever since we won the semi-final against Sheffield United. The atmosphere about the town, around the city ground, it's been exceptional. So for us to put on a performance, for all the fans that have turned out today, it's brilliant.
It could have been automatic promotion. You were very close near the end of the season, but this is the best way to do it, isn't it?
Yeah, from where we were at the start of the season, we had no right to win automatic promotion, so doing it this way was a great way to do it anyway.
It has been an incredible turnaround this season since Steve Cooper came in. What have been the major differences that he's implemented?
I think he just gave all the players confidence. He's freed the players at the top end of the pitch up, and ultimately they've won us the games.
And you've experienced some special times at the City Ground, especially this season, but what is it going to be like having Premier League football there?
I can't even imagine what it's going to be like, but it's something we're all looking forward to.
Well, it's Scott, you're the Sky Bet man of the match. There you go. Cheers. Congratulations. Thank you.
Scott McKenna aptly there describing just what this season has meant to Nottingham Forest, given where they were when Steve Cooper took over. And these are nice moments, aren't they? Really enjoying themselves. And why the hell not? You've got the players there that play such a key role. Steve Cook, Brendan Johnson, Bree Samba, the hero of the semi-final, a second leg. The champagne is definitely going inside that trophy. And I've got a feeling that won't be very empty over the course of the evening. Ryan Yates also there playing a key role. That's the big question, isn't it, Stu? I mean, you've seen teams climb up into the Premier League, water the division, etc, etc. This, to me, looks like the best way ever to get into the Premier League.
There's no doubt about that. On a one-off occasion, this is a wonderful, wonderful way of getting promoted, especially the way Forest have done it, especially with Forest's weight and their history as well, you know, going back into the 70s when club were gold of this team. But this team now, it's their job and this group of players and the manager's job to create the next chapter of history in Nottingham Forest.
And it's important, Michael, isn't it? Football, the championship, it's a long, hard season with lots of demands, lots of commitment. These moments have to be enjoyed properly, don't they?
It is a brutal league, and to arrive in the Premier League, what an achievement, and you have to celebrate now here. You see Ryan Yates, what a great lad he is. Yeah. I played with him. This does everything right, you know. And now, this is the moment where you just enjoy the supporters, soak in the atmosphere, because this is amazing. This achievement, mamma mia, mamma mia.
But again, Joby, when you see all the players here get involved, Steve Cooper obviously leading them back to the promised land. We just saw Joe Lolley there, didn't we, as well? Yeah. He's played a key role in this kind of holding pattern for Forest until Steve Cooper came in, took them over, evolved them, got them back there. This is a huge team ethic, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. And every single person there, not just the players, has played a part. And I think this is why these days are so special, because there'll be a lot of people behind the scenes that do so much work to get those lads out, ready for games, ready for finals, that don't necessarily get the credit. So it's a really massive day to for everyone to get involved, say thanks from a playing point of view for all that hard work. And it's a day that everyone can enjoy, share and look back on, because that's the big thing. We don't always have these big highs in our careers. You get to the end of it, these are the ones that really stick with you, you know, in however many years time. It's something that you've done as a group that you can always look back on and enjoy.
Well, the players are quite rightly enjoying themselves. Ryan Yates has joined us today, just now. We just saw him celebrating in front of that. And apologies for shouting it, Ryan. I'm going to have to shout. Yeah. This is insane. This is absolutely crazy. Can you tell me at all how it feels?
I've lost my voice.
But if you do that as well, we're out of our chat.
I've lost my voice, to be honest. It's incredible. Yeah. They're incredible. We come out for the warm-up.
Yeah.
Incredible, they've been like this all season, at the City Ground, travelled in their numbers, this is for them.
And it's propelled you on, hasn't it, over the course of the season? As a team, as an individual, you've just got better and better and better, and you peaked here at the right time.
Yeah, I wouldn't say I don't think it was our best performance, okay. But it was probably better than our second half against Sheffield United.
Yeah.
We got that goal, and then naturally second half, I think we're always going to sort of sit in that low mid-block.
Yeah.
You know, we're defending really, really well.
With the boys, but certainly what we've seen from afar anyway, there's been such good times at the City Ground this year with a cup run and various other games. You know, you could see it brewing and the excitement brewing from afar. So fantastic achievement and big impact next year, hopefully.
Honestly, I can't wait. I'm already looking forward to it, to be honest. It's going to be extremely difficult. We're going to make signings, but, you know, bring it on. We haven't been in the Premier League for 20 plus years, so, you know, let's just go and attack it.
Ryan, you know what it's like coming through the academy as a local boy, not just for the football club, but for the city. How big is this?
Yeah, we needed this. We needed this massively. In terms of the football club, there's been some dark days, especially since I sort of broke into the first team. You know, I was with Hef in the dressing room, and he'll tell you it wasn't the best of times. We weren't getting the best results.
But we had great banter, my friend.
Great banter, but terrible results.
No match for that. You deserve this, Ryan, my friend. You deserve this. You worked so hard. Now tell me, what are you doing now? This is the most important question. Forget about the game. Now, what is the match plan after the game?
Yeah, recovering.
Yes!
No, we're not. We're out tonight for sure. We need to party. I need to forget about football. God, ever since, say, the Fulham game, when we had a chance, we kept winning. We had a chance of automatic promotion. Went to Bournemouth and, you know, we didn't perform. I think the occasion got the better of us. But, like, that's, you know, puts in really good shape this sort of game. You know, when we don't step up and try and play and, you know, we go long and, you know, that's not us. We need to try and build from the back, get people out of position, and we tried to do that today, and that was a big learning curve, that game.
Ryan, I'll be honest, this is way too much detail for you. You've got some celebrating to do. Yeah. Give me your microphone.
Go and celebrate, my friend. Congratulations. Well done.
Right, yeah, it's their key part to get Nottingham Forest back to the Premier League. Also a key part, Jack Colback, who's now talking to Jonathan Oakes.
Yeah, well, what a season it's been. Now do you have some of your emotions now that it's ended in promotion?
Yeah, it's unbelievable. I'm lost for words, really. We've worked so hard all season. Obviously, the start of the season we had was a dreadful one. The new manager comes in. And then we didn't quite get that. You've got to get all obviously were very threatening on the counter, so you could see they were sitting in. Second half they had a change and they came out, but I felt like we were in control the whole 90 minutes. We obviously didn't play as well as we could second half, but in a occasion like this it's about winning the game, and that's what we did.
And their penalty appeal, the long VAR check, how much of a relief was that? Was there any contact from you?
I caught my ball, but I felt straight away like he's initiated the contact. Well, still, when you know you've caught him, I'm thinking someone behind the screen might see it differently, you know, so it weren't the best, to be honest, but thankfully it went in our favour, so yeah, happy days.
Nottingham Forest, such a famous club, back in the Premier League now. Do you think you've got to play for the club to really understand how special this club is?
I have, yeah, especially this season. You know, I've been here a good few years now, and the aim was always promotion, and we never quite did it. We've had some bad spells where it's been tough, but as a player, you've got to stay level, you know, because things can change, and then us as players have got to give something back to gain the fans coming like this. And, you know, it felt like a home game today, to be fair, and they've been different class all season. But yeah, the history of the club, the managers always remind us of what a big club it is, and, you know, to get to the Premier League after so long, and, you know, the boys in there, a lot of young lads, and then I said to them before, I said, you know, you might not achieve anything as big as this. And it was up to us to go and grab it, and we did that.
Thank you, Jack. Go and enjoy it.
Top man. Thank you. Cheers.
And they are certainly going to enjoy themselves tonight, the Nottingham Forest players, in front of that end where the Nottingham Forest fans are packed into Wembley. A real sense of the reflection of the team spirit, the collective commitment involved in what it's meant to be a Nottingham Forest player this season, getting themselves back into the Premier League. And of course, the players are very important, but the most important man, as always, Steve Cooper, the manager. Steve, congratulations. Any way at all that you can put this into words, how it feels?
Probably not at the moment. Maybe I'll be a bit more articulate in the days coming. Really pleased for the players, really pleased for the supporters. I thought we played well first half, apart from being too creative. And then we got of all the good goals we've scored this season, we get one like that, but it doesn't matter. And we've managed to see it through, you know, in the second half, but everybody connected with the football club, you'll know as much as me, deserves it today's, and you know, we're really looking forward now to a positive future.
There was a great shot of you at the end, sat on your own in the dugout, and I could feel the relief pouring out of your body, going and sitting down, taking a minute.
Yeah, yeah.
What's that? Is that cementing what this means to you? This feeling's going to last a lifetime, surely.
Pride, I think, more than relief, of course, but pride. I mean, I love being at this football club. It isn't about me, but it's changed my life.
Yeah.
You know, professionally anyway. And, you know, my family are here, and the players' families are here, and the supporters are here. So it was just, Stuart will tell you more, and you know better than me, that this football club for me is about belonging of a city, and it comes together on a match day. And, you know, we brought Nottingham to Wembley today and took over the place, and here we are in the Premier League.
We spoke about it before kickoff, didn't we, Stuart, about this side standing on the shoulders of giants. Yeah. But they are writing their own history now, the history that players like you helped to create.
Yeah, well, more importantly, it's about what history is created. It's about today, it's about tomorrow, and it's about the future for this football club. Today, the future looks very rosy. There's been some dark times, let's say, potentially, with the club not being able to get back into the Premier League. So you can't understate what this man next to us has done by getting the club back up. To try and get it up, a lot of people before him have tried and failed. It's not easy going into a football club with a big, big reputation that Cluffy started many, many years ago. But listen, you should be very, very proud of this achievement, I think.
Unbelievable job, isn't it?
Unbelievable. I just want to go back to the fans and the history behind the football club, Steve. You've embraced it. You know, you've gone and you've found old legends. You've embraced them. You've brought them in. How important has that been to you to maybe take that burden away from the players and embrace it and use it to spur you on?
Yeah, I mean, I get that, and I don't quite understand why you wouldn't do that, you know. And you walk in and it smells of history and tradition, and the photos that you see, this man's, you know, all over the place. And embrace it, like you said, stand on the shoulders and try and create a positive next step, because this football club is built on positive eras like that. So we want to be proud of that. We are proud of it. And but at the same time, we've got to think about what if we can get to the Premier League, what if we can play some attractive football, what if we can develop young players and give them opportunities to thrive on a big stage. And that's what we've done, you know, with a commitment and an attitude to not get beat, to stand up for the club, for the city, for each other. And we deserve this today, there's no doubt about that. We deserve it.
No, we were all tempted there, just looking behind us. That's a sense of camaraderie. I thought.
Yeah, I know. I said,
Steve,
do it.
You got
it.
That's paying the price for being popular, Steve. You're obviously too nice to him.
Well, I said, don't do it, and he said, do it. So that's for the Nottingham Forest connection there, Stu. Past and present. Eh?
That shows exactly what you've created, doesn't it?
The culture.
There's a synergy between you all.
The culture's been amazing. How can I talk normally now? The culture's been amazing. You know, we've had many setbacks along the way, and all the players done is respond. We've only lost two games on the bounce, I think. You know, so the players deserve this. For me, recovering from setbacks defines who you are. You know, and you know, it's what I haven't mentioned yet is credit to Huddersfield. Yeah. I was stood here.
Tough game, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. You know, they've been brilliant this year. Carlos is an outstanding coach.
There's not only one Steve Cooper, there's two Steve Coopers. There's another one flying around somewhere.
Carlos is an outstanding coach. We have a lot of respect for each other. We do actually speak to each other. And we knew it was going to be a tough game. You know, they set up tactically, they test you. But we really needed to go into the game today believing in how we play, how we work, and then in the end that's what we've done. And the first half really is for me was the most important phase in winning the game.
The most relieved man in that bundle just then was Michael Heffler, given what he's wearing and the shoes that he's got on as well. He stayed well aware. Steve Cooper was on his own there was no help at all from the Heff, was there? But what a job this man's done,
Stevie. Honestly, brilliant job.
Thanks, Mike.
You see the team spirit, what you created, not just with the team as well with the supporters. When you stepped in, you were bottom of the table. How get you the buy-in for all the players and all the supporters?
Because
you changed everything.
It's a difficult world now. It's a great world and a glamorous world being a footballer and a manager, but it's also a harsh and spiteful one as well. And I just wanted these players to know that I'm the biggest supporter, and I will love them and give them everything through thick and thin. Doesn't mean I'm soft with them. Doesn't mean I'm not demanding and challenging. I'm probably the hardest at that. They would laugh to hear me say what I just said. But in the end, you know, everybody loves to be loved, doesn't they? And, you know, that's what we've tried to do with these with these players. We've just really got behind them, you know, and stuck with them, give them a lot of time. Coaching staff have been amazing. Yeah. Alan Tate, Stephen Reid, Danny Olcoff, Stephen Rands. They've stuck with me, Dave Tivy as well. And, you know, we've put a plan in place and it's worked.
Well, Steve, I mean, following your career today has been a joy. World Cup winner, of course, with under-17s, moving mountains with Swansea, now climbing Everest with Nottingham Forest. You need to go and celebrate with your team.
It's been an absolute... Yeah.
We'll give you a towel, but we've run out. But well done, mate. All the very best in the Premier League as well.
As well. Really
Steve Cooper
it.
There, the man, the mastermind behind Nottingham Forest, climbing back into the Premier League for the first time in 23 years. A close game here at Wembley, a thrilling game at Wembley. They've gone up as the Championship playoff final winners.
I'll be dancing.
Wembley, of course, is the only place if you are a winner, and that's what Nottingham Forest are. Does generate the starkest contrast in emotions of what football brings to us. It's sheer euphoria in Nottingham Forest dressing room. They're back in the Premier League after 23 years. Huddersfield Town, though, did run them very, very close, but for a couple of key decisions, it could have ended all very differently indeed. The thoughts of Terry's boss, Carlos Corbrand, and more reaction after the break.
Right at the top. We've done it the hard way. We suffered this year. We had disappointment, but the group's incredible, you know. That's no good. It's not good for my hair. I'm thinning out already. They're a great group, and to be involved, to only be here 4 or 5 months and experience this, and at a club this size, is beyond imaginable. So yeah, ridiculous, unbelievable.
Bournemouth went up, you've gone up. I mean, this is the perfect outcome for you, isn't it?
Yes, it started off as a really bad season for myself. I eventually paid my way into the Bournemouth team, and we've both been promoted, so it's an absolute dream season. Oh my God. Lyle Taylor's just absolutely deafened me. It's a dream season to see Bournemouth go back up, and to be promoted with Nottingham Forest is a dream, and I've actually become blind and deaf. Incredible.
Stings when it goes in your eyes, isn't it?
Does it?
What's the plan tonight then? I expect it'll be quite a lively one, judging by this.
I think we're going to go full Jack Grealish. We saw obviously the celebrations, and we dreamt it'll be us, and it's the only time that I'll probably have the ability to be Jack Grealish, and I'm going to enjoy it.
You've seen what Premier League football is like at Bournemouth, and what is it going to be like in the City Ground next season?
Do you know what? I don't know. It's going to be incredible. Every one of these players now needs to step up. Fans need to go again, because the Premier League is relentless. But Forest, they're a club that should have been in the Premier League years ago, and now we need to do them proud in the highest league in England.
Well done, Steve. Thank you
very much. Cheers, man.
Some serious shit. Cooper said to his team after the game.
A couple of things I want to say to you, all right? I just go back to that meeting that we had. We spoke about family, okay? Make sure you spend time with your family today, the people that have been good to you in your life, because there won't be anybody prouder than them, okay? All right? And the second thing is, welcome to the Premier League!
Really is an amazing thing to see, and it is a privilege when we cover it here on Sky Sports. Opinion, conjecture, we've heard a lot of it over the course of the game today with my three wonderful studio guests, but right here today at Wembley there is an irrefutable truth. After 23 years, Nottingham Forest are back in the Premier League. Well done to everyone involved at the City Ground. From us all here, summer well, and no doubt we shall see you all very, very soon. Good night.
Couple far from
if
than
you wanna know something about me, the blood in my veins is full of northern grit. I got that northern soul, man, I go back to them. We're far from ordinary people. If you wanna know something about us, the hearts in our chest are full of northern love. Even when we're broke, we'll always have enough. We're far from ordinary people. I see the raindrops falling again. We look up to greet the heavens. Who cares if we are harsh beginnings? We look onwards. If you wanna know something about me, the blood in my veins is full of northern grit. I got that northern soul, man, I go back to them. We're far from ordinary people. We're far from ordinary people.